The wife of the Lagos State socialite, who was based in Dubai, Kayode Badru, aka K-Money, who met his ordeal during a prayer session at Celestial Church in Lagos, has come out to say that the family of the late husband are accusing her that she conspired with the prophet to burn her husband to death. Hi guys, you're watching MChiki series. If you're a new subscriber, thank you for your support. I quite appreciate that. It's good to have you around again. And if you're new to this channel, thank you for clicking on this video. Make yourself comfortable as we get right into this video. Also, hit that red subscribe button. Turn your notification bell on. That way you get our latest update. The wife of the late Kayode Badru, who lost his life during a prayer session in Celestial Church in Alabado, Lagos on May 5th, 2021, has come out to tell people that the family of her husband, her late husband, they conspired against her. They got her arrested, saying that she conspired with the prophets to burn her husband to death. So I don't know why is it that whenever a woman husband dies, the woman will pass through a lot of ordeals. You have to go through a lot of mental stress for you to prove your innocence. The husband was based in Dubai, so when the husband came for prayers, he went to Celestial Church for prayers. According to them, the husband passed on after his ordeal in the church. The body caught fire during prayers. That during the prayers, they light candle, so the pastor now sprayed perfume, which made everything to get exploded, and it became a full-blown fire that engulfed him, and they were not able to save him. They rushed him to hospital, but when he got to hospital, it was difficult for him to recover from it.
These are some of his burial pictures. I don't know why authorities in Nigeria, they don't want to get things right. Why should they allow big churches run without fire extinguishers? And why don't big churches get fire extinguishers in their churches? These fire extinguishers are very basic. These are part of the things you need in your home, so that in case of fire outbreak, you have something you can rely on to put off the fire. Some people don't consider it very important, but it's very important. I assure you that if there had been any fire extinguisher, at least this guy would have survived this. He wouldn't have been consumed by that.
So according to the report, that the man flew into the country from Dubai for graduation of 4 people that he sponsored to Academy for Innovative Art and Technology, and that the incident happened at that church during a church service, during a prayer session, whereby he was asked to kneel down in the middle of the church with many candles lit around him while he was also holding a candle during a Thanksgiving service. The man of God then sprayed perfume, like I said before, on him during prayer, and unfortunately it caught fire with the help of the candles. Perfume is highly inflammable substance, so when you spray it, it's released into the air. Combining with oxygen and the fire, it will become very explosive. So it's not even a good thing spraying perfume around where there is naked fire. It's even written on it, don't spray into a naked fire. But sometimes I wonder if all these people read instructions before they use any substance. You're supposed to read the instruction to know the do's and don'ts, because all these are flammable substances, and that was how this man lost his life.
Which means it can easily catch fire because it has a lot of alcohol, high percentage of alcohol in it. And I also hear when people talk about hand sanitizers, you don't need to apply so much to yourself and bring fire close it, because that one also contains alcohol that can easily attract fire. It's highly flammable also. And that was how this guy just lost his life. It's very painful. People need to do better. And this is just a careless death that would have been avoided if all the instructions have been followed as regards praying perfume where a candle is lit.
Now, they have started disturbing the wife, saying that the wife is behind his death. So I don't know why the family should come after the wife
when it's clear that it is an accident. So the lady said that this her brother-in-law, Wenga on the picture, beat her on the day of her husband's death for failing to greet him while they were at the mortuary. Then the next day, the whole family instructed her to move out of the matrimonial home, that they wanted to lock the house. As if that was not enough, she was arrested on Thursday, July 1st, 41 days after her late husband's death. And this woman has 2 children, I think one 3 and the other one 1. And according to the report, she was detained at the police station after her in-laws filed a petition against her for allegedly conspiring with a prophet to delete her spouse. According to her, the man wrote a petition against her at Alagbom police station. In the petition, it was written that she is an orphan that conspired with the pastor to delete her husband because of money. and she was also accused of moving and selling her husband's property on the night of his death. The woman laments that she's going through pain despite having a child that she needs to tend to. She claimed that she was released on bail and was asked to return to the station on Monday, 5th of July, 2021. This is really, really sad. I don't know why some family do this. Whenever the man dies, they will hold the wife. Even when the wife is innocent, they don't care. They'll still hold the woman. I don't know why they do that.
It's a very common thing I've seen. Even when the woman does not have a hand in it. I know some women, they might have a hand in their husband's death.
But some people don't. But you see them being subjected to the evil like this simply because nobody could talk for them. Nobody. Because they don't have anybody that will speak on their behalf.
There was another story, I think in Anambra, where a woman was made to swear an oath
that she never had a hand in the death of her husband. So what they did was that
they washed the cups, then the woman would drink the water. But the woman eventually did not do it. She has to call these human rights people to speak on her behalf. Eventually, governor's wife was also involved and they were able to save her from that. If not that the woman knows the way to go about it. Some people have been passing through this process. Some people have been subjected to this inhumane treatment, nobody to speak for them.
This is simply barbaric. Why should a human being subject another human being to this kind of inhumane treatment?
I think it's so barbaric because maybe there's microorganisms, you get infection, pass on as well.
Then the next thing you hear is that the idol, the oracle, has taken her, that she was the person behind her husband's death, when in the real sense of it, probably she got infection from the concussion and that made her to pass on.
This is becoming so embarrassing that in 21st century, people are still reasoning like this. You marry, your husband passes, they will ask you to swear an oath. This is really what I can't wrap my head around. It's so bizarre, it's so barbaric.
So let's just imagine that this situation is flipped, that the woman is in the man's position, is the woman that lost her life. I bet you nobody will come up with this kind of issue. Nobody will talk about it. The best thing is that the man will mourn the lady as much as he can and get on with his life, marry another person. Nobody will start questioning him how the wife lost her life. So that's the problem with our society. Women bear the brunt whenever anything like this happens. Everybody will focus on the woman. Because it's the man that lost his life. He happens to be a woman. Nobody will talk about it. And life moves on. Now, they've started this case. This woman has two children. Nobody's talking about how they will take care of the children. I can tell you for free, now this case has started. They will extend this treatment to the children. They will not even talk about the children again. Because they believe that the woman is behind their brother's death. Therefore, they don't care about the children from the woman. I hope they're able to resolve this problem so that the children will be taken care of. And I don't even know how they managed to know that it's the woman that sent the husband to early grave. How did they know that? Who told them that?
All these ones that are saying based on speculations. And when it comes to things like this, you don't use speculations for that. You don't speculate. You have to find evidence and facts for you to move on with that.
So when he was rushed to the hospital in Bagada, a family member went to visit him there and he opened up to him saying that the pastor allegedly was involved in sending him to early grave, that there was money involved in that, that he believed that this was not natural, that something must have influenced it. However, that he will fight after he has gone. That was what he said. So I don't even know how they managed to bring in the wife in it.
So let me know what you guys think, because I see it as a common practice in Nigeria
where the family members always accuse the brother's wife of sending their sons to early grave, even when they don't talk about it, even when they don't discuss it, they don't want to carry action. But deep down in their heart, somehow they'll be looking at the woman with one side eye as somebody who is responsible for the death of their brother. And I have also realized that once somebody passes, there must be a cause for the person's death. People don't believe that people can just give up ghosts ordinarily. Somebody can pass on. Nothing is ordinary when it comes to death. I don't know why people are like that. They also find one controversial theory to peg it on somebody. So I don't know why people are wired like that. They always think that there is something extraordinary that caused somebody's death, that somebody cannot die out of a natural cause. Some people even say that the person gave up the ghost because the person has committed one sin or the other. They must surely find something to say. So let me know what you guys think. Leave your comments in the comment section below. I'm gonna sign off here. Stay healthy and safe. Remember to share this video with family and friends if you love it, and subscribe to the channel if you've not done already. And I'm gonna catch you guys in my next video. Bye and remain blessed.